கிறிஸ்து சுவாகம். The third chapter is Vibhuti Pada. The first one, Samadhi Pada, gave the whole spectrum, summarization. The second chapter, Sadhana Pada, gave us the techniques of yoga, methods of yoga, including the Ashtanga Yoga, particularly the Bahiranga Yoga. In this third chapter, he looks the higher dimensions, dharma, dhyana, samadhi, and beyond samadhi, what are the techniques to go above samadhi. So, as I was mentioning, the dimension of dharana. Dharana is to focus the mind on a single thought. Dharana is to get down with the mind. Yesha bandha chittasya dharana. Fix the mind on a single thought. Not only when you look at the mind, the grossest form is the chanchara mind, the hapadar mind, the rukhi mind. Jumping from one subject to another, one subject to another. So what do we do? To bring the mind on a single subject, but multiple thoughts are there, but they are all connected with one another. That is concentration, ekagrata. That's what we all do. Now, when you are hearing this lecture, your mind is in the phase of concentration. But in between, the mind will think of something else, that becomes chanchalata. From there, we have to go to the next step. That is Patanjali's contribution. He says, from multiple thoughts, you fix the mind on a single thought. In chanchalata also there are multiple thoughts, concentration also there are multiple thoughts. But what is the difference? In concentration, all the thoughts are linked with one another. There is a logic that comes. Whereas in the dharana, the next step, you fix the mind on the single thought. Complete focus on the single thought. So what is the result of that? Thought becomes very, very powerful. You can go deep down and purify ourselves. All of our subconscious can be completely cleansed. But dharana cannot be done for a long time, because it is very strenuous. Even if you do dharana for even 1 minute, 2 months, you start getting a headache. Some people say, sir, I started doing meditation, but I started getting headache. That means they are doing dharana, they have not come yet to dhyana. So from there, dharana, you go to the dhyana. Dhyana is a wordless dharana. You must fix the mind on a single thought, the wordless thing. And the speed of the thought is going to reduce, slowness. When the effortlessness of slowness comes, invariably our tendency is to go to sleep. No sleep. You have to keep awake. And you start feeling elated, you start feeling expanded, your mind starts expanding. These are the 5 features of dhyana. Tatra pratyaya ekadana dhyana. Single thought, slowness, effortlessness, wakefulness, and expansiveness are the 5 features of dhyana. And dhyana is opposite of concentration. In concentration, you are speeding up the mind, faster mind, quicker mind, great mind, dynamic mind, faster, faster, faster. Whereas in dhyana, in the reverse. Why do you say that concentration goes? Imagine that she reads 20 pages in a hour. Whereas she reads 40 pages in a hour. Who has got concentration? Naturally, she. Therefore, in concentration, the number of thoughts per minute is going to increase as you increase the concentration. Whereas in meditation, it's opposite. From 100 thoughts, you come to 50, 10, 5, 2, 1. One single thought. One single thought per minute. One single thought per 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour. Stay the single thought. Therefore, concentration is opposite of meditation. Meditation brings deep rest to the system, rejuvenates us, and there is a reduction in the metabolic rate. Whereas in concentration is the reverse, there is a faster. When you stay in the dhyana for longer and longer time, it takes you to the samadhi. So, what is the definition of samadhi? The word samadhi comes from sunyat adhiyate iti samadhi. At least the mind gets absorbed in this thought that you are having. Whatever thought you have taken, you are Ishta Devata. Let us say that you are meditating on Sri Ram. Ram, 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 you are doing. So you are there as a meditator. Rama, the object of meditation, and the process of meditation, repeating Rama, the pilot. So meditator, meditated, and the process of meditation. This is called Tripudi. In all the transactions, you always have the Tripudi. You are there, you are walking, you are coming to Mangalamande. You are eating, you are there, the food that is taken in the process of eating. In all the transactions, we have Tripudi. But when the three things merge together, you become Samadhi. You become one with a single thought. That's called Samadhi. Then what happens? As if you have lost person. Tadeva Arthamatari Bhasa Swarupa Shunyamiva Samadhi. That's how Patanjali defines. As if you have lost person. Because you have become one with the object. That is called the Dhyana, leading to Samadhi. So Ashtanga Yoga culminates in Samadhi. Samadhi dies. Yama, Niyama, Asana, Pranayama, Pratyahara, Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi. So Samadhi is the end and the culmination of Ashtanga Yoga. But that's not the end. Many people think that Samadhi is the end. In fact, Patanjali emphasizes Samadhi is the real beginning of higher yoga. So everybody should get the glimpse of Samadhi. It's not difficult. Every one of you can get it to 3 times in an hour and dhyana. Same meditation you are passing, you are practicing, go deeper and deeper and deeper, and you will learn deeper. So your objective of your avartan dhyana, the cyclic meditation, is to get a glimpse of that samadhi. Then from the research you have to be called higher things. So what next after samadhi? You must learn a special technique called Sanyama. There is Trayam Ekatra Sanyama, he says. Dharana, Dhyana, Samadhi, put together. Forms Sanyama. You start with Dharana, go to Dhyana, from there go to Samadhi. So this process is called Sanyama. All the three things coming together, Panapranada, Panapranada, coming in sequence. And take it to the stage of Sanyama. So Sanyama is a special technique up to the Samadhi. Unless you have a glimpse of Samadhi, you cannot go Sanyama. You know? So next step to Samadhi is to get the Sanyama. And what is the result of that? Tadjaya Pradna Lokaha. So if you develop this capacity to Sanyama, then you start getting the Siddhis. The supernatural powers, and you get the conquest of absolute knowledge of the ultimate reality. So, how it has to be done? You have to be done in the state of Bhumi Shuddhi Yoga. You do that systematically in the aforementioned successive steps. Successive steps was Dharana, Dhyana, and Samadhi. Successively. You are not going to do that. So, Bhumi Shuddhi Yoga. Samyama has to be practiced by doing that. First take an object and say Ram. Sri Ram. Focusing on that Sri Ram's picture. Then staying longer and longer, make it effortless, slowness, single thought, wakefulness, expansiveness. Become bigger and bigger and bigger, expansive. And you become one with that. So this is the one that is done in Bhumi Shuddhi Yoga. This is how we have to say it. Okay. Then compared to this, all other things also become Bahirmya. Compared to Sayama, even the Samadhi becomes Bahirmya. In Ashtanga Yoga what you say, Dharana Dhyana Samadhi Sankarna, Yamaniyama Sampranaya Pratyahara is Bahirmya. But compared to Sayama, this Dharana Dhyana Samadhi becomes Bahirmya. This becomes Sankarpa. And then now means you have to go deeper and deeper, Sukshma, at the end. Then you become Nirbhijas. Even this stage, the Sayama and the other things, compared to Nirbhijas, samadhi becomes bahirga. So bahirga, antarga, bahirga, antarga. It goes on. As you grow deeper and deeper, the antarga becomes itself bahirga. Then you go to the hyena, 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 and then you sleep. So then he starts telling, doing sayama on what? What type of siddhi is that? So when you do the sayama, a particular thing, you get the knowledge, you get the whole process unraveled, the secret gets unraveled. So when this happens, what happens? There's a transformation that takes place. That's called parinama. A transformation of the body takes place, transformation of mind takes place, transformation takes place, and you go to the higher thing. This is the transformation that comes, talk about. So there are three types of transformations that he talks about. The first one is called Nirodha Parinama, then Samadhi Parinama, then Ekagrata Parinama. So how this has to be practiced, he is giving the technique. How to do this Nirodha Parinama? It's very advanced technique of Parinama. Is that parinama? Yuthana Nirodha Samsara Yoga Abhivaho Pradur Bhava Nirodha Kshanahitvanvaya Nirodha Parinama. Yuthana Nirodha. Other two things can happen. Yuthana means in the mind, the thoughts arise. And then the thoughts subside. Nirodha and Yuthana. Yuthana and Nirodha. When this is happening, then Abhivaho Pradur Bhava, and they are coming up and going down. Nirodha Kshana. When the Nirodha taking place, when it's silencing, silencing. At the end of the silencing, there's going to be a transformation that occurs. So that transformation is called as the Nirodha Parinama. So thoughts come, thoughts go, going to the silence, and transformation occurs. Then it's called Nirodha Parinama. Then, that's the Prashanta Vahita Sanskara. Then you get higher and higher bliss, peace and knowledge at this level. Then we have the next parinama called Samadhi Parinama. Sarvarthata Yakakradayoho Kshayodaya Chittasya Samadhi Parinama. Then what happens? When the mind becomes silent, a transformation takes place. And again, the mind will have a number of different thoughts. Sarvarthata comes. And then you are going to bring down into the single thought by dharana, dhamma, samadhi, then you get into the silence, then you get into this. This is called the samadhi parinama. Sarvartha ekagrata yoho. Yodakshana unmadhyaha samadhi parinama. Then you have a single thought, continuously in that. That is called the ekagrata parinama. Three types of parinamas have been talked about in the whole process. So this is advanced technique. This is mechanisms, in a sense, as talked about. How there is going to be a transformation that takes place has been brought forth in this. Once you start doing that, there is going to be different siddhis that start coming. Supernatural powers come. You want to know about the complete body anatomy? Namachakre, Sayamar, Payavyosnanam, say. At least if you put the sayama on your nabhi, nabhi chakra, and stay there, enough, then you know all that's happening in the body. You have complete anatomy, well brought forth. You want to know about astrology and the various things that are available, systems. Dhrude, karabhi bhagnanam. So you fix your mind and pole star, and do the sayama. Then you get the knowledge of all the stars that are there in the whole world. So like that, Patanjali gives the different sayamas to bring about the different knowledge and different things. Similarly, you want to fly. Guru Samapati is the Akashavanam. Guru Sayama on a light things like the cotton. You fix your mind and cotton, you think that you have become like cotton, go on doing that, the body goes up and down. So like the various types of samadhis have been talked about, including astasiddhis, adhima, mahima, garima, prakamya, all these things also can be got that of Sayama. So Sayama is the method by which the knowledge unravels and the transformation takes place and you get supernatural powers. How karma was able to get cast into this? By doing this Sayama. And she Ram, 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 Ram. And you get all the powers that come up. So this is the higher dimension. This has to be ended up. Hardly we have that capacity to that. That meditating on the full star, that gives you all the knowledge of this constellation, all the constellation there. So as a provider of his life, for all the things. And you can go, till they allow you to have none. So like that, he describes all the different languages. That is the vibhutis. They are called vibhutis, they are called the supernatural powers, and they have complete release of the bondage. What are the bondages? Bondage of this body, bondage of the knowledge, bondage of the emotions, everything there. That bondage will go away by doing this dimension. Then you go to the higher dimension. That is what? The samadhi. Therefore, as you raise higher and higher in your samadhi, moving from vipara, vipara, ananda, svita, vipara, samprajnata, tadaniha, samprajnata, any type of samadhi, you get different powers started. And the greatness of Patanjali is, he describes how to do that. What are the techniques available? By doing what, you will get. So you want to be very, very strong. You will get 10,000 elephants power. So what is the thing to be done? He says you have to do on Vajrakaya. You have to do Sayama on this thing. So like that he gives, whatever you want. So our initial seers used to teach all their students with these powers, how to get this power. Therefore they used to be very, very powerful. And they can get these things done. So a science is behind the whole process, which the modern science has not unraveled. Because in modern science, we have gone only after the concentration. We never came up with the dharana, the dhyana, the samadhi, and the samadhi. So, after the samadhi, the sayama, and the transformations due to that, and the transformations bring about various cities. So, this entire thing is totally unknown to us today in the modern times. Modern science is only up to the level of concentration. So, Patanjali gives the parapsychology, you can say, the supernatural dimension. Then how does this happen is brought about in the fourth chapter of the Kaivalya Path. That he brings about the knowledge base as to how this happens. How can you transform this body into divinity? How can you make this body prayer? Well, obviously impossible. But there is a science behind it. Just like in the modern science we thought that energy and matter are two different things. How can you convert matter into energy? How can you say matter is energy? How can you say energy is matter? But we have been able to show through experiment. You build a nuclear reactor in which the matter is converted into energy, uranium. Similarly, a cyclotron can convert the energy back to matter. This has been shown by experiment by the equipment. Similarly, Patanjali was able to show this dimension. So what is the science behind it? The modern science will come with the equation. E equals mc square. E is the energy, m is the matter, c is the velocity of light. So you can actually calculate how much of energy is in given matter. For example, if I convert this into energy, could be energy. This can completely burn up the whole of the degree area. Such is the immense energy packed into matter. So the equation, the mechanisms, the understanding has been done in modern science. Similarly, Patanjali has given the mechanisms, the knowledge by which you have this process that occurs. How does that occur? He says that we have been made the karma. Every action we do has a particular result. And that brings a samskara within us. So the three types of samskaras, tamas, rajas and sattva. So continuously our body, our mind, our emotions, everything is made out of the three gunas. And during our life, we have the freedom to change it. Tamas can be reduced, rajas can be controlled and sattva can be developed. This is what we have to do. If you don't do that, you stay where we are. Tapas will continue, sattva will continue, and then breath will continue, same proportion. And therefore, yoga is to transform ourselves. The tamas has to be reduced, the rest has to be controlled, sattva has to be developed. This is a transformation that we have to do in our yoga practice. And we have asana, pranayama, mudra, asana, astriya, this is what should happen. The tamas should reduce. If we are still doing 8 hours, 10 hours a day, we should reduce to 6 hours, 5 hours, 4 hours, all reduce. And if you are very rasi, kama, krodha, lobha, moha, madha, matsarya, day by day the all should come down. And sattva should develop that you are becoming a better human being, great human being, super human being. Even if you start giving and giving and giving, your contribution to society will become more and more as you grow further. So when these things are happening, you are on the right path. This happens in the mind, essentially, and brings about a change in the body. So if the body also will get changed, your tamasic body, you become more rajasic body, you become more sattvic, and this is how the physical transformation also starts happening and is done. Then at the end of your life, you have reached certain level, and then this is all stored as karma sheshas, as samskaras. Samskaras are stored in your gunamaya kosha. And when you leave the body, you are in the gunamaya kosha, and vijnanandamaya kosha should be there. And when you come back, again next body, after some time, again these things which are there as samskaras will come back again to this. So you have a suitable body, a suitable mind, and the same type of the emotions that you have accumulated there. There's a continuity of life there. Birth and death goes on and on and on. And we have the opportunity to change and develop in every life that we have. So when you come into this dimension, then you start going beyond the gunas, that is from the samadhi. So you start experiencing the samadhi, in which you start expanding to higher level. You start understanding the realms of pranamaya kosha, manomaya kosha, vijnanamaya kosha, anandamaya kosha. One by one you start unraveling the secret and knowing about the knowledge, about the equation, about the structure, everything you start understanding with a total transformation. Not only your body will become free from all tensions, stresses, diseases, but you start getting higher powers, positive health, and supernatural powers start coming up. And great fighting talents will come, and creative features will come, innovations will come, all these things will start happening when you go to the higher branch. And these are the dimensions that Patanjali has given. So how does that happen? By transformation. So in the physical world, we have this transformation called transmutation. For example, you have got an atom, and that atom changes itself into a new atom and releasing some amount of energy from this atom. This is what happens in the nuclear reactor. The structure itself will change. Similarly, the body structure itself is going to change, mind structure will change, and your structural transformation starts taking place. This all is described in great detail in the fourth chapter by the process of transformation of your samskaras, karma sheshas, the pura karma, the present karma and the future karma. All these things have to be transformed by using our prina. We all have a prina. We have to use that to bring about the changes. So that gives you the whole spectrum of the Rajyoga Patanjali. You can see the schematic in which it gives you the whole picture of the Rajyoga, starting from Yama, Niyama, the do's and don'ts, and come to the asana, use asana to gain mastery over the mind, and we have pranayama, use breathing and prana to gain mastery over the mind, pratyahara, use the senses, reduce the slavery of the senses towards the sense object, that is the pratyahara. By this Bahiranga Yoga, you indirectly handle the mind and gain control over the mind. Then direct control over the mind, Antaranga Yoga, dharana, dhyana, samadhi. Fixing the mind as a single thought, then staying there for longer and longer duration, dhyana, and getting into the samadhi. Samadhi is an explosion, is an expansion, is a quantum jump at the mind level. And from samadhi, you go into the next step, or the sayama, prayamekata sayamaha. From there you go to the higher and higher light, the dwarfs Raja Yoga, unravel the mysteries. Ultimate unit, that kaivalya, ultimate goal. That's also known as moksha. Infinite knowledge, infinite power, infinite freedom, infinite bliss. That's our swarupa. That's our original state. From original state we all have come. From that infinite soul, the whole creation has come. All of us are born. So these are the dimensions that they have given, and the schematic that gives you the dimension of Atman Yoga, what is Raj Yoga. Therefore, we have Jnana Yoga, Raj Yoga, Bhakti Yoga, Karma Yoga, and the main things. Using this, we have been able to apply this to various aspects of life. So in our university, and people said, how can you have a university for yoga itself? Because they did not understand yoga. They thought yoga means only asana. But yoga is such a vast thing as we have now understood. So using that, we said, we are going to have five divisions in our university, as you know. Division of yoga, spirituality, in which we go into greater depth of the understanding, the practices, the techniques, and all this that we are talking about. Brahma Sutra, the Nathabhak Sutra, Patan Sutra, Karma Yoga Sutra, all this is study by studying these things and understanding and using the practice, transforming yourself. That is basic sciences, something very difficult. Division of yoga, spirituality is something like basic sciences. Then we have the division of yoga and life sciences, applications to various aspects of life, that the health sciences, the neurosciences and all these things, applications to health, particularly Arogya Dham. We have got a health center here in which we deal with all diseases and modern non-communicable diseases, NCDs, particularly we have no solution in the modern medical world. Once you have become a diabetic, once you have cancer, but yes, and number have come to pass. Why? You don't understand the totality of the NCDs. You understand only what happens in the physical body in the modern science. Therefore, you try to deal with the body alone. You get deeper and deeper levels. You may do to work at the muscular level, nervous system level, and cardiovascular system level, or you can go even down to the genes level, or in the brain level. But everything is the body, nothing beyond that. Because you don't know what is prana, you don't know what is mind, you don't know what is emotions and others. Whereas yoga has unraveled all these things. Therefore, we understand that all these senses start in the Manomaya Kosha as Adi. And that Adi comes down to the pranic imbalance and brings in the body of the atomic imbalance, the endocrine imbalance, and the stress reaction, and causes the Vyadhi. Adi of Vyadhi, that part. Unless you remove the Adi, you have no solution. So what we do here in the integrated approach of yoga therapy is that we deal with man in his totality, remove the Adi, you have a total solution. So that's how we apply in various health conditions, and we have worked with all number of people. And we have got wonderful research. We have been able to publish papers in the best journals, like British Medical Journal, Oncology Journals and others. And this is the specialty of our institution. Among all the institutions in the world, we stand number one in terms of scientific research. And our research lab, Professor Visit Malveshna, is the number one and the best lab in the country, in the whole world. Because we can measure what's happening in the body, including gene sequencing, gene expressions, everything. Not only that, we can measure prana, and we can measure the mind, the emotion, the intellect, everything we can measure. You have the equipment for that. And therefore, when the people come, we measure all dimensions and use the techniques of yoga to normalize that. Another dimension is, here we not only use yoga, modern medicine, we have got Ayurveda, we have got physiotherapy, the acupuncture, the naturopathy, everything in one group. This is the integrated center of health promotion. So this is how we have set up this Arogya Dham, a 350-bed facility here, and people come from all over. And yesterday, our team, new people have come, and I welcome all of them to our Arogya Dham. We get wonderful results. People who come with tremendous amount of problems of diabetes, they are taking insulin after insulin, and they have been able to reduce insulin, they get to normalcy. Such miracles happen here. Every week there is a miracle here. People come in stretchers, they go walking. People come in wheelchair, they go running. Things happen. This we want to replicate throughout the country, and that is the holistic health program that we have for the whole country. And to scale up, we got this diabetes control program that we took up 2 years back, based on the teachings of directions for Prime Minister of the International Day of Yoga. He said, government and yoga institutions should join together to combat diabetes and prevent India from becoming the diabetes capital of the world, he said. So we scanned 60 districts, 2.5 lakh people in just 3 months, and give them the yoga practice, and see how results have come. The biggest project that we have done. Now based on that, now this has become a national program. For Health Minister Nadaji has said, as we are going to launch it as our national program, and it will go to every hospital. This year we have taken a cancer control program. Oral cancer, breast cancer, and cancer survey. So we have a lot of research already in this dimension, and we have shown that yoga could be very, very useful in doing that. Particularly what we are going to do is, in 120 districts throughout the country, we are going to scan 2 crores of people. And we are going to give an awareness program so that you can have early diagnosis. Once you have early diagnosis, cancer can be prevented. And prevention and promotion of positive health. Here are the yoga techniques. So RCT trials, mechanism study. And when the cancer patients go into the third and fourth stage, then unfortunately there is no enough support system for them. As I said, they suffer and suffer and suffer until they die. There's too much pain, agony, nausea, headache, and weakness, and the tumors and others. But the yoga dimensions can add on dimension. What medicine is a very painkiller, maybe a marking, very high level opiate. But what you want to do is bring out the entire dimension program. So this is called integrative palliative care dimension. So what we are going to do in all the hospitals in the country, we are going to have 10 beds reserved for this integrative palliative care. And we have to have all the groups of people trained, consulting doctors, nurses, and yoga therapists, or Ayurveda therapists, we want to train them. The next 2 years, about 2 lakhs of people we have to develop to make this possible. Otherwise, we have only 0.4% of the people who have access to the palliative care. We want to do this dimension. It's a big project that we have taken. And into these projects, you are most welcome. For that, what you have to do, we are going to have a training program. After this YIC, we have 1 week program for yoga volunteers for diabetes mellitus, UIDM. Similarly, we are going to have a week-long program for yoga volunteers who want to take care of this integrative palliative care. So this month, from 31st, we are going to have a 5 days program for training the people for this integrative palliative care to take up this integrative cancer project. We call it as ICAP. So if anybody wants to join this thing, you are most welcome. Already from UP, we are sending the 18 doctors from 18 different mandals, and similarly from other places they are all sending, and if anybody wants to join, you are most welcome. Similarly, our expanding work here, these small number of people who can contribute, dedicate themselves and come up here. We want to have people who have got experience in various fronts, management system, the campus management, garden development, and taking care of the maintenance and the research dimension, all this. And if you people are interested, you can, you are most welcome to apply, give a CV. I know many of you are very intelligent, very brilliant, you have a lot of experience. You want to come over into this field, YIC is a good background that you have got. If you are YIC, you can join hands. And our work is spread throughout the country and also all over the world. We are working in 30 countries. So many people who want to have access to the outside world also, you can come. Japan has spread so much, and similarly other countries also, we have 30 countries we have work. Those people who want to do that also, will undergo the training and see that you'll be posted to different countries. And particularly if you already have the visa, it becomes easier. Otherwise getting visa may be difficult for this thing. So these are the opportunities that are available to you, and therefore whoever wants to join hands, you give a full CV, full biodata. Maybe some of you are BE, some of you are IT specialists, some of you are doctors, some of you are other people. You give a complete CV so that you will process it and you will have an interview before you leave, and you can join. If you want to join the Shanti Kutiram here, we have a number of corporate MDs, you can do that. And this is why, this is how we are going to do that. And we are going to have our university, Vivekananda Yoga University in the United States and in Los Angeles. Another 3-4 months we are going to get the accreditation by the BPPE there, and we are going to have all these courses done there in the United States, and we can do that. Similarly, our Andhra Pradesh government has come forward and given us about 65 acres of land in Vizag, and we are going to start an off-campus center in Vizag in which this will be replicated dimension. Similarly, we are expanding in different parts of the country and all over the world. China, we have our access and then MOU with different universities, and see that what grows. In every stage, we got our best research going on cancer in MD Anderson Cancer Center and University of California, Los Angeles on the irritable bowel syndrome. Similarly, different things are going on all over the world, and you are most welcome to join hands. And particularly when you are trying to shift from even presenting to a new dimension, the YIC is a must. Therefore, you all are doing this YIC. At the end of this YIC, you can have this dimension. With this, let us conduct today's talks. Subscribe, the door is closed. Take a deep breath and slowly breathe out. Relax all parts of the body, the spine and the face. Calm down your mind. Relaxation of the body, slowing of breath, calming down of mind are the three cardinal principles of yoga. Let's work on that. Calm down the mind, silence the mind. Silence is peace, peace is bliss. Let us spread the fragrance of bliss to everyone whom we meet today and keep ourselves smiling, santosha, throughout the day, full of joy. Because we have Anandamaya Kosha as our causal body. To be happy is our birthright, as Swami Vivekananda said. So, develop this habit of being happy all the time. Come to Namaskar Mudra.